Who should we say alayhi salam? Alayhi salam can be used with anybody. So you can say Mihwish alayhi salam, Asim alayhi salam. There's no problem in that. There's no restriction. It's dua. So there's no problem in that. Unfortunately, later somewhere down the line, this was preserved for messengers and prophets and angels and righteous people. So when we say Maryam, the mother of Jesus, we say Maryam alayhi salam. When we mention the name of Jibreel, we say Jibreel alayhi salam. When we say Adam alayhi salam, all prophets and messengers, the Prophet, our Prophet Muhammad, we say alayhi salam or alayhi salatu wassalam, which is the best and the most appropriate. Later down the line, in some of the late generations, they associated it with Ahlul Bayt. So the Rafida Shia, whenever they say Ja'far al-Baqir alayhi salam or al-Husayn ibn Ali, they would say alayhima as-salam, Fatima alayha as-salam. And this is inappropriate. One would say, oh, we know that Imam Bukhari mentioned in one of his narrations that Ali alayhi salam and Fatima alayha salam. This is one single narration. And it's not the trend. It could have been a mistake. It could have been an error made by one of the scribes who copied the Bukhari and he added it instead of writing radiyallahu anhuma, because we know that radiyallahu is what the majority of Ahl Sunnah attach to the names of the companions. So it should be like this. But if someone says alayhi salam, we say Ali and Fatima alayhim salam, as well as Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman alayhim salam. There's no problem in that. But to only single out Ahlul Bayt with alayhi salam and no one else, no, this is an innovation and Allah knows best.